Hi, good morning. My name is Elizabeth Budde. I'm a hematologist from Department of Hematology at City Hall Medical Center. So today I would like to talk about the work that we are part of, which is combining mosunetuzumab in combination with polatuzumab for patients with relapsed refractory B-cell non-Hodgkin lymphoma. So this is a multicenter study in patients with relapsed refractory lymphoma, especially the patient with aggressive B-cell lymphoma, including patient with high-grade B-cell lymphoma and patient who fail CAR T-cell therapies prior to enrolling onto this treatment. The therapy regimen is combining a bispecific antibody targeting CD20 and CD3, as well as a antibody-drug conjugate, which is polatuzumab, which recognizing the CD79B antigen on the surface of the lymphoma cells and tagged to a payload. The overall response rate is quite high, and complete response rate is seen in more than half of the patients, to be exact, 54.5%. And in follicular lymphoma patients, a few of them were included in this study. Now we saw 100% patient responding with complete remission in 4 out of 4 patients. So this is quite encouraging. And the main reason that I think this combination really worked is because the one is the non-overlapping toxicities. As we know, bispecific antibodies, just like other cell-based therapies, can cause second release syndromes and other treatment-related toxicities, which is not commonly seen with antibody-drug conjugate. And in these studies, the bispecific antibodies actually had more favorable side effect profile than, say, a CAR T-cell therapies. We have not seen a single patient with ICANS neurologic toxicity. And second release syndrome is also quite low. No patient with grade 3 and above second release syndromes, and all the toxicities are reversible. So the good things about including an antibody-drug conjugate, one is to allowed us to target different antigen on the lymphoma cells, which gives selection pressure, make it harder for the lymphoma cell to evolve. That's one of the reasons there's increased efficacy in this combination in comparison to a single agent, for example, by specific antibodies or single agent antibody drug conjugate. And second is we are still learning how this combination works, but given the different mechanism of actions, antibody-drug conjugate does not really rely on the endogenous T cells or endogenous NK cells to help out with the efficacy. What it does is a targeted delivery of a payload, which is a chemotherapy-based treatment that will allow to debulk the lymphoma cells, regardless they have the antigen that can be recognized by the bispecific antibody or not. At the same time, because of this targeted treatment, it doesn't really impair the endogenous immune cell numbers or their efficacy. Meanwhile, the bispecific antibodies is able to get to the lymphoma site, recognize the lymphoma cells, and recruit immune cells, in this particular case, the immune T cells. So in combination, this targeted chemo-based treatment to debulk and to likely increase the accessibility of the lymphoma mass, allowing the bispecific antibody to work better. So together, the efficacy seems to be better than each individual single treatment. And there's really no increased toxicities that we have seen in these first 22 patients. We have treated more patients now, and hopefully in the near future, we'll be able to present more data. But I can say this, we continue to see pretty high efficacy in these patients, and patients continue to do well, and patients actually able to have most of the treatments in the outpatient setting, and some of them are able to continue to work full time. The only time they take off from their job is really coming in to have the infusion treatment. So this is a quite promising outpatient regimen with novel combinations, mostly based on what we learn about the immunology and how immune system work, taking advantage of this immune mediated reaction that help us to get rid of the patient's endogenous derived lymphoma cells.